Hey, this is John Hams with the LBL Group, where we're using benefits, technology, and healthcare strategies to help employers solve the healthcare crisis for themselves and their employees. Let's dive into some stats on why the healthcare system is so broken that explains a little bit about the strategies and ideas and things that we're trying to do to help employers. Let's dive in. So today we're going to look at four key stats to explain why the healthcare system is so broken and why we're doing what we're doing to help employers manage healthcare costs and improve benefits for their employees. The first and one of the most jarring ones is that 50% of Americans couldn't afford a $400 emergency expense. You may have already heard of that number, but it's particularly jarring when it comes to healthcare when the average family deductible is $3,700. For 50% of employees who couldn't meet that $400 emergency expense, their family deductible for their healthcare plan is multiple times that. So that is a really good starting point for why we need to take inventory and we need to address cost drivers and plan design issues when it comes to employees' healthcare plans. The second one is about how costs have continued to rise for employees' healthcare. Wages have been fairly stagnant for the last 35 years in real terms. And over that same period of time, healthcare prices have nearly doubled. And so there's a huge disconnect there where healthcare prices and healthcare expenses are now taking up a significantly larger portion of the average American's budget. That's a very big deal. It's not very sustainable, and we need to fight back against that and lower that percentage. As a reminder, a lot of healthcare spending goes to waste. So it's not dollars that are really directly and positively impacting employees' outcomes. There's a lot of opportunity there for us to reduce that total cost and help that match with employers' financial situation. Another huge issue that we're seeing in healthcare today in America is the significant evidence of health disparities across racial boundaries. So when we look at cancer survivors, 23% of Black cancer survivors on high deductible health plans have skipped medications, whereas that figure is only 8% for white cancer survivors on those same high deductible health plans. So that's a pretty big disparity. When skipping medications and not following guideline consistent care, that has a very big impact on health outcomes, increased expenses for the employee and the employer. Reducing these health disparities is going to go such a long way to us improving overall quality of outcomes for employees, reducing overall spending, and generally improving people's quality of life. Finally, we need to question how the economic system is being rewarded for what's going on in healthcare. So when we look at the last 10 years since the passage of the ACA, the Affordable Care Act, the S&P is up about 175%. Meanwhile, health insurance carrier stock values have nearly tripled. And so when we see that kind of outperformance by these companies who are in the healthcare space, we really need to ask ourselves, how are they positively impacting health and how are they being rewarded for that? And the reality is that our healthcare outcomes are not getting better, and yet their stock prices are increasing. And so when we pay extra money into our health insurance premiums, we need to wonder where that money is going and what it's doing for our outcomes, how it's improving our quality of life. And the fact is that as you can see from all of these economic statistics, we can do a lot better. It's one of the main things that's driving us today in the work that we're doing with our employer groups. We want them to deliver benefit plans that improve the quality of life for their employees from a health standpoint and a financial standpoint. We can actually do both of those things together with a lot of the healthcare strategies that exist out there nowadays, whether it's care navigation, plan design, contribution strategies, and overall economic theory when it comes to managing the healthcare supply chain. We can do a lot of things to help employers today. The key thing is that we got to work with employers who are interested in thinking about the long-term future, they're interested in making changes, and they're interested in improving their employees' quality of life. Again, this is John Hams with the LBL Group, where we're using benefits, technology, and healthcare to help employers address the healthcare cost crisis and increase and improve their employees' quality of life. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks and have a great day.